Hey guys, this is Anand here and it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it.
Hello and welcome to Mad Stuff with Rob. I am Rob and today's DIY is a simple paper craft that makes amazing and complex looking paper baubles. In fact, when I was a kid, we used to buy a lot of these to put up on the tree around Christmas time, and I used to always wonder if I could figure out the technique to make them. And then I did. And the technique is so simple that it will blow your mind. So get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. And to make the paper baubles, you need to grab a few items. Here's your list. All right, let's get started. So for these paper baubles, you need to design a template because we are going to make a honeycomb structure. So let's start with that. I have a sheet here and a bowl. I'm using the bowl to make a circle. You can use a bowl or a plate or even a compass to make a circle. And the size of the bowl will actually define the size of your paper bauble. So the bigger the bowl, the bigger the bauble. Okay, now with a marker, I'm going to draw a circle. There you go, we have a circle. Now I have to divide this circle into 6 equal parts to make the honeycomb pattern. Okay, so we'll name them. The first one, A. We'll leave the second. The third will again become A. And the last one will also be A. And then the rest will mark B. And this is your basic template to design your hexagon paper bauble. All right, now let's make the paper bauble. For the bauble, I'm using kite paper because it's thin and it's translucent and you get them in different colors. So you can choose your favorite colors. I'm going to make white. So the first thing I am going to do is, I am going to stick this in place. So we'll apply a little on the corners. Okay, so I've placed the first one and you can see that I have kept the circle right in the center of this square sheet. And that's what you need to do. So take a glue stick and make a nice clean line. And you have to keep in mind that you have to only go over the A lines, just like that. Now take another sheet, align it, and stick it in place. Now we'll repeat the same process and apply glue on the lines that are marked B. And you can see because of the template, it becomes really easy. And you have to keep repeating the same process, alternating between A and B. And you have to stick about 20 sheets to get a nice hexagon pattern. Okay, I'm done with the 20 layers. Now what we need to do is, you need to take a circle out of mount board or box board, basically a thicker paper. Now the size of this circle is exactly the same as our bowl size. And now we need to fold this in half, like this. And that you can match to the center line right here. But before that, we'll also take a rough measurement for dividing it horizontally, like that. So we have these two marks. Now we'll apply some glue. All right. Now this first crease line is to match the center line right here. So we align it, press it, and stick it. All right, this is done. You can see we have our 20 layers. You'll see we're already getting a hexagon pattern. Okay, now we are going to cut it in this circular shape. Now, following this marking, I will cut it horizontally in 2 halves. So now I have these 2 equal halves and we have to stick them together. Now to stick these 2 halves, place the first one like this. Now take a glue stick and again apply glue on the line marked B, like that. And carefully place the other half on top of it so that both the halves stick together. That's it. That's all you need to do. But before you open it and see the hexagon shape, you need to do one more step, which is tying the corners. So for that, we'll take a thumb pin and an eraser. And what I'll do is place the corner on the eraser and then just press the thumb pin like this. We'll do the same thing to the other side. And here you can see I have a hole on either side. Now we'll take some string. I'm going to just pass it through the hole like this and then tie a knot. Now when you're making a knot, make sure it's not very tight so that the bauble opens easily. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. And with that we are done. We have our hexagon paper bauble. Tied a loose knot on either side and stick these two ends like this. And your paper bauble is ready. So you can see I have them in different colors. Now you can put them up on your Christmas tree or hang them individually next to your window in your room, or make a whole string of baubles, or you can attach them to a tree branch and get creative with it. So you saw how simple the technique was. And you can use these paper baubles for any season, any occasion, any festival decorations, or a simple room decor idea like we just did. And I made white ones, but you can use colorful kite paper and make them look really colorful and amazing. And it's such a simple technique, but makes complex looking structures. If you enjoyed watching this video, then please give it a thumbs up, like, and share it with your friends. And also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Just do it, it's free. Also, in the comment section below, let me know if you have any ideas, suggestions, or feedback. I'll see you next time. Until then, do good and be good. Peace.